Good evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. The year was 1983. Ronald Reagan was president. The Big Chill was the big hit movie, and a swatch was the latest fashion accessory. It was also the year Channel 8 broke broadcasting ground with the first live airing of an open heart surgery. Dr. Ted Diethrich of the Arizona Heart Institute performed the heart bypass surgery at St. Joseph's Hospital. Former Horizon Science editor Richard Dolly, now a medical doctor himself, co-hosted the show. And Jeff Hallberg, now the production services manager at Channel 8, directed the live broadcast. We should note that there are graphic surgery scenes that we will likely show during the interview, so be prepared. Dr. Diethrich, I want to start with you. Were you prepared for all this? How did all this get started?
Well, I think we were approached from somebody from ASU, because that was the source of this at the beginning. And the idea was very small. It was just to maybe show an operation, show part of an operation. And the purpose was to, in my mind, was to educate the public, because I always had this idea that if a patient or a potential patient had knowledge about the procedure, and if they could see the procedure and be assured that it was something that was correct and easy, and so that's how we went about this. The thing is, though, it exploded beyond my ever thinking it would be so great. I was flying back from Chicago, and I had this idea with Dick Williams, who was our VAS producer then. And I got in town, and I said to Dick, you know, we're putting a lot of effort in this, and the folks from Tampere are putting a lot of effort into this, and where are we going to show this? Because the idea was, I think it was the idea, pretty local, whatever the local audience was. Well, it turned out, at the time of the operation, people in London could have been having their afternoon tea and see this operation live. And afterwards, of course, I always travel a lot around the world. And every place I went, people said, hey, we saw it on TV. So, however you guys arrange this, I don't know what you did, but suddenly it went way beyond the Valley of the Sun.
Was that the idea? Dr. Diethrich mentions education first and foremost. Was that the idea, and how do you think that turned out and how it progressed?
Ted, that's exactly right. I think the genius behind this was a fellow general manager of KAET at the time, Chuck Allen. Has been called, I believe, a maverick of sorts, but he was an absolute genius, and it was his desire, his goal, his motivation that this be a true educational experience, that people who were facing this operation, and it was proliferating widely across the states, could get a sense of what it was going to be like, what it entailed, what it meant, that the outcomes were often fantastic, as Dr. Diethrich's patient was indeed. And I think it turned out exactly to be that way. I believe the reason why people in London and everyone else saw it, and Jeff can speak to this, is that it was sent up to the PBS satellite, and right. I believe repeated several times. In fact, I had a friend of mine who was in Israel who wrote back and said, I saw you on TV, and I thought, how did you do that?
It just kind of evolved. You know, we were going to do this show and it was going to be local, and then we started thinking about it and it made the decision to, you know, put it up to the network and see if they would go for it. And many cities decided that they would run it, and a number of them decided, no, that's, you know, too weird for us. We're not interested in that. But it ran in, I forget the exact number, but it was like 90 cities or something.
Yeah.
A big number of the PBS affiliates took it.
In preparing for the broadcast, what did you do? How did you, obviously television shows are blocked and they're scheduled, there's pre-planning, pre-production. We're talking heart surgery here. What kind of planning was done here?
A lot, a whole lot. And, you know, from my side of the street, I had to figure out how we're going to shoot this and what needs to be covered. So I talked to the doctor and the hospital and made arrangements to go and sit in on several open heart procedures and stand in there by the table and, you know, watch what they do and learn the movement and talk to everyone and figure out what's important, what can we show, what shouldn't we show, kind of a thing, and where can the cameras go, and, you know, just the whole thing and the whole flow of what's going to tell this story, what's going to make sense to our audience, what is the flow in the operating room, and try and make sense of all of it. So we had to make those decisions, there's a lot that had to be done.
Okay, and I want to show a quick excerpt here from the show. This is the first view of the heart. Let's go ahead and take a look again from 1983. And this again, this is live television, the first view of a heart that's being operated on.
Now this is the first view you have of the heart. We'll open our sternal spreader a little more. We can place a silk suture along the pericardial sac, and it will give us a good view here of the ascending aorta. Here's the ascending aorta now. This is a large vessel that comes from the heart, the left side of the heart, and supplies the blood to the entire body.
Doctor, when you're doing, it's amazing. You're speaking, you're performing, you know you're on television. I mean, the fact that you knew that this was going out on live television, did that ever enter into your mind, or was this just another procedure?
Well, I guess it had to enter my mind somewhat, but I grew up in my early training years with Dr. DeBakey and Dr. Cooley in Houston, Texas, and they were excellent in terms of producing movies that were teaching movies. And so what you saw there, I was doing the procedure, I was talking about it, but I didn't hesitate anything because it was just part of the maneuvers, your technical maneuvers you were doing. And so when I came from Baylor College of Medicine and started the Heart Institute in 71, I had a lot of experience in these kinds of productions.
As far as being one of the co-hosts of the program, your job was to help explain what was going on along with the doctor there in the surgery room.
Yeah, I jokingly refer to it as the color commentator.
There you go.
Yeah, I was the John Madden back then. We had two folks on the set, myself as the science editor, but we also had Sam Kinard, who was a wonderful cardiologist and part of the team. And the two of us held as best as we could in times when Dr. Diethrich was doing something particularly difficult and wasn't talking. You know, you asked Jeff just a minute ago what went into the preparation, and one of the other, I think, absolutely terrific educational things that Chuck Allen had me do was to prepare the audience ahead of time. We went out and did a number of stories that we showed on Horizon, science segments on cardiology, everything from Barry Goldwater's operation. He had a cabbage, as you know, a bypass graft.
It was Keeping in Touch with Your Heart Month. We had that whole special in February was Keeping in Touch with Your Heart, and we did stories about heart or heart stuff all month long, and this was the culmination.
We led up to it with
finale.
A number of stories, yeah.
Well, you mentioned that, leading up to it in that respect, and yet we just saw a beating heart on our screen, and you saw it 30 years ago. And Jeff, I mean, for some folks, this is a little squeamish. This is tough to take. Was it difficult for you as a director? How about the crew? Did anyone get a little squeamish during this?
We had some, it didn't bother me at all. I'm just totally into this stuff, and it's very fascinating to me. I don't have a problem with it. I mean, I went into the operating room a lot and stood right there and was like, what's that? You know, tell me about that. It's fascinating stuff. We had some crew members, though, that, they did okay, but they struggled with parts of the show.
Let's go ahead and take another look, quick excerpt from the program. This is now when you found the blocked artery and told the audience that this is basically what you were here for.
Dr. Kinard, what we're doing now, we have found the main artery that was blocked coming off. We've also found a posterior descending coming off of the circumflex. And we'll bypass, I think, those two arteries. We'll probably do a jump graft from one to the other.
Doctor, when you watch this, when you first watched the completed program on tape after everything was said and done, what were your thoughts?
Well, first of all, I had to compliment the team because you notice there's no blood. You notice there's the blue towels, the draping and everything. That doesn't just happen. And we had a wonderful operating support team, the scrub nurses, the circulating people, and so forth. And they helped make this a smooth, I used to say that let's make the operation like a symphony, and we like a symphony orchestra, and that's what we tried to do. And I, when I saw this, I was very proud that this number of years ago the team could perform that way.
When you see this now, Rick, and yeah. you know what happened back then, the first time you actually sat down and watched the tape, and they used tape back in those
yes,
days of
did.
These kinds of broadcasts, what were your thoughts?
You see a human heart beating, and you say to yourself, it's a miracle. It's a miracle. How, you know, all the technology, all of what we do in medicine, and yet it still haunts us that this is what we are really all about. This is humanity. This is a beating, living organism.
And Jeff, when you look at it now, think about it back then. First of all, were there any surprises during the broadcast?
One surprise for me in the production truck. I don't think there are any surprises in the surgery. Everything went very smooth. But one surprise for me that happened was, we're right in the middle of the program, and I'm in the production truck in the parking lot of St. Joe's Hospital. And calling the shots, and we're doing our work, and I'm right by the door of the truck, and it opens up, and I look out, and it's a newspaper photographer, and Kalink flash cube goes off in my face, and I said, thank you, and close the door, and now I've got a big purple spot in my field of vision for the next 2 minutes, and it was very hard to see the monitors. That was a surprise. I was not anticipating
that. Yeah,
that
constitutes
no other
a surprise,
though, and there could have been many, but everything else went really smooth.
Let's take another quick excerpt here from the show. This is now a final shot of the finished bypass.
We might want to show one good final shot. Dick Williams is our overhead photographer on the boom. Dick, you might want to come down on the heart one time so our viewers can see how beautiful the heart is, the beautiful color, and the function, as these bypass grafts are working very satisfactorily, bringing new blood into the heart muscle.
Just amazing stuff. Doctor, last question for you. What kind of reaction did you get from this?
Not so good. It was the first time that this had ever been done in the world. And you can imagine that physicians, cardiac surgeons, wrote editorials. They thought that it was a totally inappropriate thing to do. It was risky. It didn't do anything positive for our profession and for cardiac surgery. And so wherever I went for some period of time, I was approached with that question and sort of challenged why would you do this? And I kept coming back with the same response. I did this because unless we physicians take the responsibility of educating the public about what we're doing and how we can prevent this kind of disease, which we've always worked on here for so many years, then we're being irresponsible. So I didn't think doing the procedure was irresponsible at all.
What kind of reaction, Rick? I mean, that's a surprising reaction.
That's a surprising reaction, but consider the source. These were colleagues or other physicians who, for some reason, I don't know whether they were threatened by what Dr. Diethrich did or what the motivation was, but I can tell you anecdotally, what about the response that we got from viewers? It was sensational. Letter after letter that came in, for example, to me saying, how wonderful, how courageous, how fascinating, how absolutely important it was that we did this.
And Jeff, when you look back now, memories of this particular production, what do you got?
Very proud. Just an amazing, amazing process, and learned a lot. And, you know, again, the whole reason we did this was to educate the people and our audience, and to just quash any fears. I mean, people, this is such a common procedure, and it even was back then. If you're thinking about having it, well, they show it on TV. I mean, you know, don't be afraid. It's okay. And you know, go ahead and talk to your doctor and see if this is going to work for you. But very proud.
Well, gentlemen, congratulations on the 30th anniversary. It was a tremendous achievement and a tremendous milestone here at Channel 8. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate
Thanks.
It.
Our pleasure. Thank you.